Pakistan's Supreme Court rules the arrest of former Prime Minister Imran Khan is illegal. The court decision comes 2 days after Khan was arrested in Islamabad on corruption charges. His arrest triggered nationwide protests that killed 8 people. 2,000 others were also detained in the unrest. His supporters took to the streets Thursday to celebrate the court's ruling. According to one of his aides, Khan remains in the court's custody for his own safety. The graft case is one of more than 100 registered against Khan, which, if convicted, could disqualify him from holding public office. Russia denies reports that Ukrainian forces had made a breakthrough in the flashpoint city of Bakhmut, even though the claim came from pro-Russian sources. Russian military bloggers earlier reported that Ukrainian troops made advances in the north and south of the eastern Ukrainian city. Some even suggested the long-awaited counteroffensive by pro-Kiev forces had started. But on Thursday, Moscow's defense ministry asserted the military situation in Bakhmut remains under control. Ukraine has said it has pushed back Russian forces near the city over the past days, while it prepares for a full-blown counteroffensive involving tens of thousands of troops and hundreds of Western tanks. Israel kills the head of Islamic Jihad's rocket force and his deputy, while Palestinian rockets inflict their first fatality in Israel. The deaths of the two Islamic Jihad leaders have brought to 5 the number of senior figures from the Iranian-sponsored group killed since Israel began striking Gaza early Tuesday. But the operations have also caused the deaths of more than 20 civilians, including women and children. The latest escalation in regional violence has prompted international calls for a ceasefire, but mediation efforts by Egypt have so far failed to yield results. The Philippines hosts a fleet review of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations. 9 navies, including those from the Philippines, Singapore, and Indonesia, took part in the exercise off the coast of Subic Bay. The fleet review is part of the ASEAN multilateral naval exercise aimed at enhancing interoperability and readiness among partner nations.
So ang natin dito, ang ginagawa natin to is not against to anybody else, but to unify. Look for the common good or common ground so that we can harmonize ourselves and see the ASEAN region. Yung sabi nga natin, even though we are small, but when we gather together, our voice for peace and prosperity for the ASEAN region and also the Indo-Pacific will be louder and bigger.
A Virginia federal judge rules that individuals below the age of 21 cannot be barred from purchasing handguns. On Wednesday, U.S. Senior District Judge Robert Payne wrote, banning 18 to 20-year-olds from gun ownership would be unconstitutional. That decision comes in the wake of several mass shootings across the nation. The Justice Department is gearing up to challenge the ruling and push for limitations on firearms purchase. The ruling will not take effect until Payne issues his final order in the coming weeks. One person died after a crane collapsed on top of a moving train in Taiwan. Local media reported the incident also left 10 people injured, while some passengers had to walk along the train tracks to be evacuated. The cause of the accident is currently under investigation, but operations had already resumed on the affected stretch of tracks early Thursday.